लास्ट क्लास वी कैन डिस्कस अबाउट बोन, टुडे वी कैन डिस्कस अबाउट फ्लूइड कनेक्टिव टिश्यू. See, in connective tissue, we having a connective tissue proper is the skeletal tissue and third one is the fluid connective tissue. Fluid connective tissue means we can discuss about blood and lymph. See, fluid connective tissue, it is a tissue. It is a tissue. Fiber free liquid matrix is present and also they having a living cells but they are not able to produce the matrix. This is the characters of the fluid connective tissue. In that first we can go for the blood. See, in this blood they having a liquid matrix is present. That liquid matrix is called as a plasma and then they having a cells, living cells, that is called as a formed elements are also called as a blood cells. Here the formed elements are the RBC, WBC and platelets. These are the formed elements. Plasma, they can be occupied by the 55%. Formed elements, they can be occupied by the 45%. Here, it is a tissue can circulate the all parts of the body by the help of the cardiovascular system. Why? Because here the cardiovascular system indicates the heart, they can pump the blood to the all parts of the body. That's why this blood can be transported to the all parts of the body compared we need water, heart. That's why it will be linked to what type of system? Cardiovascular system. Now, first we can go for the plasma. In this, see, hematocrit value. What is hematocrit value means? The volume of RBC occupied in the total volume of blood. In blood, ante blood lo RBC yanta percentage occupy ayyindo, that value is called as a hematocrit value. We can discuss about the plasma. See, the plasma consists of 92% they having a water is present and 8% they having a solutes. Now, what are the solutes is present in the plasma? The solutes are plasma proteins, mineral salts, nutrients, gases, excretory waste materials, enzymes and hormones. These are the solutes can be present in the plasma. What are the plasma proteins is present? The plasma proteins are the albumins, globulins and then blood clotting proteins is present, that is the fibrinogen and the prothrombins. It is under the blood clotting factors. See, this all plasma proteins is produced from liver. Now here the most abundant plasma protein is the albumin. It is the smallest protein. See, what is the use of the albumin means? This albumin mainly useful for the colloidal osmotic pressure in our body. Colloidal osmotic pressure means, now
in the cell, excess fluid is present. That excess fluid is eliminated from the cell or eliminated from the body by the presence of the albumin. Suppose here albumin level is decreased in our body. When albumin level is decreased in our body, what will happen? The excess fluid is not eliminated from the cell or not eliminated from the body. Now that the fluid is accumulated in the cell or accumulated in the body and leads to a swelling appearance, that is called as a oedema. That is called as what? Oedema. That's why oedema is formed by the due to the deficiency of the albumins. And then globulins. Here they having a three types of globulins: alpha globin, beta globin, gamma globins. See, alpha beta globulins can be present in the blood cells, that is in the RBC. Gamma globulins, what is use of gamma globins? Gamma globins can, they can produce the antibodies. Antibodies. These antibodies, they can attack the antigens. What is antigens? Any foreign particle is enter into your body, that is called as an antigen. Suppose a bacteria or virus is enter into our body, that is the antigens. This antigens is attacked by the antibodies. That antibodies can be released from the gamma globulins. And then fibrinogens and prothrombins, that are the blood clotting factors. Suppose if the body is injured, you can get an injury. It means from the injury, the blood is oozes out. That blood is clotted with fibrinogens and prothrombins. These are the inactive forms. Later it will be converted to the active forms. Now, plasma proteins. I said the plasma proteins, that is albumins, globulins and fibrinogens and prothrombins. These plasma proteins, they can form a, they can act as a acid-base buffer. Acid-base buffer. It can maintain the pH. Here, the pH of blood is 7.4 and it is a slightly alkaline nature. Basic nature. Slightly alkaline nature. That is indicates the basic nature. Here, and also they having a salts. What are the salts is present in the plasma? They having a chlorides. They having a bicarbonates and they having a phosphate, sodium phosphate, potassium phosphates. These are the salts present in the plasma. Now we can go for the formed elements. In the formed elements, the first one is what? RBC, red blood cells. Red blood cells is also called as a erythrocytes. Erythrocytes. See, the formation of RBC, that process is called as a erythropoiesis. Poiesis indicates formation. That's why the process of formation of RBC is called as what? Erythropoiesis. Here, where the RBC production is takes place? In embryonical stage. In embryonical stage, it is formed in the yolk sac. Formed in the yolk sac. And later, the next stage, it is the initial stage. Next stage, it is formed in the liver and spleen. Later, it can be formed in the bone marrow. That's why the RBC production, early stage, they can form in the yolk sac. Later, it is formed in the liver and spleen. Finally, it will be formed in the bone marrow region. In this, what is the characteristic features of the RBC? RBC is in a biconcave shape. RBC is in a biconcave shape. And then the diameter is the 7.5 micrometers. Why the RBC having a biconcave shape? If the biconcave shape is present, here what will happen? The surface area is increased. When the surface area is increased, more exchanging of gases is takes place. That's why our RBC is the biconcave shape. And very important one, immature RBC and matured RBC. Matured RBC, there is no nucleus. There is no nucleus. Why? Because here, If the nucleus is present, there is no proper exchange. Why? Because the nucleus, it can be occupied more portion in the cell. That's why if the nucleus is absent, instead of that, it will be having a more amount of hemoglobin is present in the RBC. Now, here, per cubic millimeter, the RBC for males is the 5 millions and for females is the 4.5 millions is present per cubic millimeters in males and females. Now, what I said, per cubic millimeter they having a 5 to 4.5, this is for males, this is for the females. The decrease in the RBC count per cubic millimeter, that condition is called as a erythrocytopenia and it leads to anemia. Anemia indicates destruction of RBC is called as a anemia. And then abnormal production of RBC, that condition is called as a polycythemia. Suppose when oxygen content will be low in the body, at that time from the kidney they can release a hormone that is called as a erythropoietin. That's why erythropoietin is released from the kidney. From the kidney they having a gland that is called as a adrenal gland. From that region they can release a hormone that is called as a erythropoietin hormone. When oxygen count will be low in the body, this erythropoietin hormone enter into the bone marrow. In this bone marrow, they having a erythropoietical stem cells is present. Erythropoietin stem cells. This erythropoietin hormone can stimulate this stem cells. When the stem cells will be stimulated and produce the RBC. When it is can produce the RBC, what will happen? In RBC, they having a respiratory pigment is there. That respiratory pigment is called as a hemoglobin. This hemoglobin can carry the oxygen to the all parts of the body. That's why, see, here the hemoglobin having a two chains. Two alpha chains and two beta. Totally four chains is present. Now, this hemoglobin having a four ions, each ion, they can carry one oxygen molecule. That's why you can write HBO8 or HBO42. Like that you can write. That's why each hemoglobin having how many ions? 4 ions. Each ion they can carry how many oxygen molecules? 1 oxygen molecule they can carry. And then the lifespan of RBC is how many days? 120 days. And then the dead or worn out RBC is present in the spleen region. That's why the gray yard of RBC is what? Spleen is the gray yard of RBC. Tomorrow class we can discuss about the leukocytes.